chapter. The Industrial Revolution was so frenetic, a man called Charles Babbage got carried away and invented the computer far too early. Modern computers are tiny, but this was as big as a transit van. It was even bigger than the 1990s one your dad's got in the loft and won't throw away in case the bin men find all his bank details and mucky JPEGs. Hello, who are you?
I'm Doran Swade. I'm an historian of computing, and I was responsible for building this engine.
So what games does it have?
It doesn't have any games.
It must have, like, some basic games, like Mario Kart or Snake or...
I'm afraid
or
not.
Or Patience, like the shittest one. It must have Patience.
I'm afraid it doesn't.
It doesn't have any games.
None whatever. It just does mathematical calculation.
So where's the screen on this computer?
A screen, again, is part of the electronic era. This has no screens. As it happens, you don't need to read the numbers because it prints them automatically for you.
It's a shame, isn't it, that it doesn't have a screen? Because then you could turn it upside down and the numbers would become rude words. You know, like with a calculator.
Yes.
Have you ever done that?
I haven't, but I know what you mean.
You've done this, but you haven't done that.
Correct.
Babbage never foresaw the terrible consequences of his invention, a machine that would auto-correct his name to Cabbage every single time. The Victorian age was an era of huge and inventive leaps. But one man was about to take too large a step for many, Charles Darwin. Darwin was born the son of a doctor, but using his own theories, soon evolved into a scientist. He was fascinated by nature and decided to find out more about it by going to sea on a beagle. Darwin sailed off on his science mission on a beagle, didn't he?
He did, yeah. He went off for 5 years on the Beagle, a small ship which circumnavigated the world.
Not a dog?
No.
So it wasn't a ship that evolved into a dog?
Certainly not, no.
On his journey, he visited the Noel Gallagher's Islands and came up with a theory that animals that were dead were less likely to reproduce than ones that were alive. Talk me through the events that led up to the moment where Charles Darwin invented the monkey.
Darwin didn't invent the monkey. No one invented a monkey.
OK, well, talk me through the events that led up to the moment where Charles Darwin didn't invent the monkey.
Charles Darwin saw monkeys as potential progenitors of humans, i.e. we could have evolved from them.
When they put monkeys in zoos, how long does it take for them to turn human?
Well, it's not really to do with the zoo.
All right, so say we kept one in the wild. How long would it take for that monkey to grow like a nose or ears?
Well, they have noses and ears that are perfectly functional.
Like a man's nose.
Those apes and monkeys don't need a human nose. It wouldn't do them any good.
What's the fastest evolution could happen? Like, how fast could you turn a pig into a cow?
A pig into a cow? You're never going to be able to turn a pig into a cow. Why would you want to turn a pig into a cow? Pigs are quite good at being pigs and cows are relatively good at being cows. Why do you want to turn a pig into a cow?
Just see what it's like.